My name is Omar Douglas, and I'm checking out Guard Your Grill Boxing.
Got my Nike boots flyed, and the rest of them flyed, and the rest of them flyed, and the rest of them still got my Nike boots flyed, and the rest of them flyed, and the rest of them flyed, and the rest of them still got my Nike boots, still got my Nike boots. Revolution will proceed. Unification, the DMV, I will achieve indeed. I decree I'm forming a new alliance. Oppose the one poisoning the minds. They lying. I am only a fighter in the form of a writer, in the form of a poet. Potency in the mic. I blank out, then I approach it. Turn me up and I go in. Haters must learn to bear. I'm Lovie Smith with the vocals. Lord, I'm so focused, more focused than I ever been. So slightly past them, like the letter N. It's DC, black jeans, black tee. It's that North Face rap. Better get me PG, Riverdale, Largo, Temple Hills, Cap Heights, 124, Landover, everywhere, Saratoga, 640, Bury Farm, 14, KEY, every corner, everybody got a moon. Fly than the rest of them, fly than the rest of them, fly than the rest of them, still got my Nike boots. Fly than the rest of them, fly than the rest of them, fly than the rest of them, still got my Nike boots, still got my Nike boots, still got my Nike boots. Still got my Nike boots, doing what I gotta do. Still got my Nike boots, still got my Nike boots, still got my Nike boots, still got my Nike boots. No congressional rappers, no respectable rappers. It's the way we've adapted, though. Get, I made it happen. Yeah, the most opinionated city you can make it in. But still a nigga made it here. I'm Neo in the Matrix, knees dug deep into the pavement. DMV, so we used to the waiting. Nobody seems to care, we so complacent with the vacancy. See, the love is gone with one another, it's hard. Nobody rep for the skins, they busy chanting them stars. It's ironic, it's the same for the artists. Rapping in by our songs, they busy chanting the stars. A lot of drama, a lot of beef, we have so much in common. Starting at the feet, go with dome mics, the quarter zone of the poem writer. None like us, so none like us. Fly than the rest of them, fly than the rest of them, fly than the rest of them, still got my Nike boots. Fly than the rest of them, fly than the rest of them, fly than the rest of them, still got my Nike boots, 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 doing what I gotta do. Still got my Nike boots, still got my Nike boots, still got my Nike boots, still got my Nike boots. Look, this where the haters is, this where they hate us here. This where I hate it here, though love it, I made it here. We all here, from the dealers to the kids, to the squares, to the fly. One thing we are aligned with, black on black mics that represent the lifeless lives. And it reflects the plight of those fighting. So if we ain't right, and always at the throats of one another, at least we got our go-a-dome mics. Metaphor for the insecure, if you ain't wearing no color, can't nobody say nothing. One can never be judged when he dressed like his brothers. Melancholy we all, though we all learn to love it. Pessimistic we all, carry ours like luggage. And through all our troubles, we still walk around, walk around. Fly in the rest of them, fly in the rest of them, and still got my life. Slide in the rest of them, slide in the rest of them, slide in the rest of them, still got my Nike boots. Slide in the rest of them, slide in the rest of them, slide in the rest of them, still got my Nike boots, 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 doing what I gotta.
What's up, man?
What's going on today?
Amateur, one of the best that came out.
Right.
Golden Gloves, all the championships you can get. So, you going pro or you going to try for the Olympics?
Yeah, I'm going pro. I was actually waiting on the call to go out to the Olympic trials, but I'm thinking about going pro because the amateurs is not really my style. I'm more of a pro fighter.
Okay. In the amateurs, you had broke Mike Tyson's record for the fastest knockout. How did that come about?
I wasn't really looking for the knockout, but I trained real hard for the fight. And I seen that my opponent kept dropping his left hand. So I came back with a left hook to the head, left hook to the body. And after that, it was pretty much it. I think it was 8 seconds. Yeah, 8 seconds. So it's kind of like as soon as I came out, I seen the opening. And, you know, I took care of business.
Did you accomplish everything that you wanted to in the amateurs?
Yeah. Yeah, I figured I would. I was actually going to turn pro last year, but I figured I'd make my last little run at this amateur thing before I decided to turn pro.
So what is your final record?
My final record is 122 wins and 19 losses. I really don't know how many knockouts I got, but I was on the streak for a little bit, so.
Okay. So what division you see yourself going in? Lightweight, super featherweight?
Probably 126, super featherweight, and 130.
Okay. If you had to describe your style of boxing, what would it be?
I'm more of a boxer puncher. I mean, that's one of my strengths in the ring. I can sort of adjust to anything. So it don't matter whether my opponent comes out boxing, then I'll punch. My opponent comes out punching, then I'll box. And I can kind of... I'm kind of versatile in there. It don't even really matter.
Okay. What made you get into boxing?
I think when I was younger, I caught Ray at the very end of his career, and me and my grandfather was watching boxing and all that. And he was like, he was very into boxing. His favorite fighter was Alexis Arguello. We watched boxing together all the time. And I remember this little story where he was like, yeah, oh, I was like, what's that thing they got under their trunks? He like, oh, that's a cup. So I went to go get a cup from the kitchen. I mean, not knowing that they was talking about real cups, you know, that we use in fights and all that. So, yeah, he bought me a speed bag for Christmas. I got heavy bag, jump ropes, you know, the whole nine.
Okay. So who are your favorite fighters that you grew up watching?
My first favorite fighter before he retired was Oscar De La Hoya. Because of what he accomplished as a boxer, I mean, coming out as a gold medalist. And him launching Golden Boy was a big thing. I mean, that boxers don't always have to throw punches in order to make money out from the sport. You don't always have to be a fighter. I mean, I think he might have been the first boxer to accomplish that. Him, Bernard Hopkins, Richard Schaefer, and all of them. And my next is probably Floyd. You know, Floyd gotta be like the greatest fighter in my era, you know, since I was coming up. And Zab Judah. That's my personal favorite fighter. I mean, even I know he had his wins and losses, he take his lumps. But at the same time, I mean, every time he comes out, I know if I pay my $50, I'm gonna get an exciting fight. It's not gonna be boring. He either gonna go to sleep, he gonna sleep somebody. I mean,
never mind about that. What would you like to accomplish as a pro?
As a pro, I'm looking to take belts at 126, 130, probably later on down the line 135, 140. I'm looking at taking four belts, unifying at 126. I mean, I see guys out there now. I know I don't have the experience as a pro fighter, but I see guys out there with weaknesses that I feel as though I can get them out of there. I mean, being a 15-0 fighter, I mean, I learned everything to get some of them up-and-coming guys out of there. Like 126, I see Wolfall last weekend. Can't think of this boy's name. Adrian Boner?
Yeah.
I think 15-0, he gonna have to see me. 16-0, he's gonna have to see me. I see Gamboa, you know what I mean, later on world title, you know, for all the belts, for all the chips. If he not done when I get there, Juan Manuel Lopez, all them guys. I actually like them guys. I mean, Gamboa happened to be one of my favorite 130s. I'm looking forward to seeing him fight this weekend and seeing him unify or whatever this weekend.
Okay. Last question. Last question. This is the hurt business, and I like to ask everybody this. Do you have an exit plan?
Do I have an exit plan? Like when I see myself exiting the sport, when I see myself being done. Wow. Probably like around 30, I'm 20 now, so this game is rough. I mean, a rough 10 years, 11 years. I see myself being done with the sport and moving on and kind of like opening doors for other fighters from Delaware. I mean, we don't get a lot of, I happen to be one of the fighters that opened doors for the fighters in Delaware, and I'm seeing myself doing other things, you know, other than boxing, like being a commentator like Roy and all them, you know, the regular boxing stuff, promoter, manager, trainer. I mean, I plan on actually saving a lot of money so I'll be able to open my own business someday. I mean, a promotion business or whatever. So I won't have to box to support myself, basically. Once I hit 130, man, I'm totally done with the sport.
Being that you're from Delaware, Wilmington, Delaware, you have the. Do you feel like it's necessary for you to go to Philly and the other states to get better competition?
Yes. There's no Delaware Golden Gloves. There's no Delaware national team. I mean, there's no national team or whatever. All the work I put in as an amateur has been in Philly, New Jersey, Baltimore. I probably had a couple fights here, but they was against guys from Philly and Jersey and stuff like that, so. Yeah, pretty much. I never really boxed down here. It's not big enough, and boxing here doesn't draw a big enough crowd for everybody to, you know, to want to support it. But me myself, I mean, I feel as though here at home, I can definitely pack arenas and stuff like that. I mean, Dover Downs, I can pack Dover Downs, possibly the Blue Rock Stadium. I think they're supposed to be having fights there. July. I mean, I might make my debut there, and I'm pretty sure I can pack a house.
Okay. What will separate you from the other guys that came out of Delaware, like the Mike Stewarts and the Sonny Bono?
My amateur background. Compared to them, I have a lot of amateur fights. I think, no disrespect to nobody, Sonny's my man. Sonny's my main man. Sonny Bono's my main man. And he showed me the ropes, but I had more. I'm pretty sure I had more. Well, I know for a fact that I had more fights than these guys. I mean, I'm more experienced, per se. Like when I'm coming into the professional game there, and I had 140 some amateur fights. My man Sonny, he didn't have no amateur background. And I'm not sure what Mike did as an amateur, but I'm coming in with experience. I'm not learning on the job, so that's what kind of separates me from them, man. Yeah, that's what kind of separates me from them.
All right, what would you like to say to your fans out there?
I want to say look forward to me coming soon. I mean, I might be fighting at the Blue Rock Stadium come July. And I'm not one to come out there. I'm not going to board y'all. I'm putting anybody I fight to sleep, especially the first 15, 16, putting them to sleep. And I'm coming to do my job. So, just stay tuned, man. It's a show, man. I got my highlight tapes coming out. All the promoters are going to be watching. I mean, managers and all that. So, just look forward to me coming soon.